Speaking to us now is Peter Zimmerman, the American musician and actor, who is currently starring as Eduardo in AMC's The Walking Dead. First things first, Peter, thank you very much for joining us. How are things with you over in Atlanta?
Thanks for having me. Things are very good. Yeah, just winding down right now and enjoying the weather. And I just finished an album, which I'm really excited about. I just released it yesterday. So yeah, life's good.
Yeah, and we'll get on to that, because of course, as well as being an actor and in The Walking Dead, you have a very successful music career. And yeah, as you said, I saw on Twitter yesterday, your album has come out, so later on we'll definitely touch on that. But firstly, on The Walking Dead, Peter, I can see from your Twitter that you've done a number of Comic-Cons in the past. Is it only when you do something like that that you realise quite how big the show you're on, The Walking Dead, really is?
Absolutely. I think that's the times where you really realise the scope of it, or at least get a sense of it, because it's people in the flesh coming up to you and you see them in thousands, sometimes tens of thousands. I remember my first Walker Stalker, I think there was 30,000 people in attendance, and it's just massive. So yeah, it's definitely a good gauge of how big the fandom is.
And what's the kind of, for people who haven't been to one of those Comic-Cons, what's the kind of atmosphere like? Is it a way to kind of go and approach actors like yourself?
Yeah, it's actually very, every con that I've done has been super laid back, in the sense of you get to meet the people that you that are on your favorite shows, and it's, the lines can be long, but other than that, it's your favorite people in the flesh that you see on TV or that you idolize. And same thing for, you know, us on the show. It's exciting for us to meet the fans and hug the people that we interact with on Twitter or Facebook or wherever it is, and you get cool fan art. So it's a neat experience for fans and us as well. So it's like nothing else.
Now, Peter, let's talk about the character Eduardo that you portray in The Walking Dead. He's obviously the person, he's quite good friends with Cal, who of course is played by James Chen, who we spoke to a couple of weeks ago. Gregory as well, he has a pretty frosty relationship with him. But for people who haven't seen the show yet, do you want to just kind of describe the character of Eduardo and what his role is at the Hilltop?
Yeah, he's, like you said, he's friends with Cal, who is also a guard at the Hilltop community. Cal and I are kind of like the lookouts. We hang out on the wall. You know, we're kind of the first barrier of protection for who comes in and out of the Hilltop. You know, as far as Gregory's been the standing leader at the Hilltop for a while now, and he's done a good job with organizing a system of survival with, you know, saviors and making sure that we day-to-day can live our lives. But he also is showing signs of cowardness, and yeah, Eduardo's not too fond of him, especially with some of the interactions he has with Maggie. You know, Eduardo kind of steps in and defends Maggie in a couple instances, and yeah, now that things are getting pretty heavy in the show, you know, not to spoil anything, but Eduardo's actually been a part of defending on the ground as well, too, which I think is pretty neat. Yeah, he's kind of in the thick of the action right now.
Yeah, definitely. And like you said, Eduardo does jump to Maggie's defense in the particular instance where I think it's Gregory's kind of eating an apple outside the gates, and then Eduardo kind of goes, well, you know she's pregnant. You should probably give over that apple.
Exactly.
yeah. Talking about Xander Berkeley, who portrays the character of Gregory, of course, there's an instance in the show where you and Cal are the people that kind of put him in the pit with all the saviors. Do you think, whilst, you know, as I've heard you say in other interviews, to be honest, Peter, you know, the character of Gregory is not a pleasant one, but is there a bit of Eduardo that you think feels a little bit of sympathy with Gregory, particularly after he kind of hits him and all that blood kind of appears?
Yeah, I think there's a small ounce of sympathy in Eduardo, just because it takes some level of leadership to get us to where we were at, you know, before the survivors got there, and being able to survive in that world is hard enough as it is. So I think there's definitely a little tiny ounce of respect there for Gregory, but it starts to diminish as things progress when we start seeing how we're being taken advantage of and how Gregory has kind of led us to that point, and then how Gregory interacts with people that are just trying to help us, with Maggie and Rick and, you know, the whole survivors group. So he definitely feels a little ounce of sympathy for him when he, you know, knocks him into a wall. I think anybody would. That was pretty intense. But yeah, he's definitely leaning more towards, screw you, Gregory, like, you had your chance to redeem yourself.
Yeah, Gregory's definitely upset a lot of people in the Hilltop, I think it's fair to say. Let's talk about your role kind of on the set now, because of course you get to work with some fantastic actors on the show. Is there anyone in particular who you have particularly enjoyed working with?
Yeah, I mean, I think all of them are fantastic. I think what's cool about being on a set like this is everybody has their own style of how they approach a scene and how they break it down. One of the memorable ones for me was episode one of this season. Rick is having the standoff with Negan, and Andy Lincoln delivered about 10 to 12 different takes of just perfection. Every take was different. It's the scene where he's basically counting down to Negan right before we all fire at the sanctuary.
Oh, yeah.
And he just did the scene. He just gave so much to the editors and the the people that I do everything in post-production to work with, because everything was believable and intense, but every take was different. And it was just incredible to see how he was able to do that spot on every single time with such different, not emotion, but just, you know, inflection on the words and, you know, different facial expressions. And so he was definitely one that I kind of took as an acting class, just being there with him on set. Xander Berkeley's hilarious. I think his character is, it can be such an easy role to hate, but he kind of makes you hate him and still love him at the same time, in terms of, you know, being this guy who's such a coward, but at the same time, he's a weasel, you know? He's somebody that you feel bad for, because it's like, you know, you never killed a walker before, you know? Maggie had to come up there and help him out, and his expressions are so big, and it's almost like this is a funny guy, but you hate him at the end of the day. So, I mean, I think that's a testament to how great of an actor Xander Berkeley is. And I could, the list goes on and on. I think that there's fantastic actors and actresses on that show. But yeah, those are two of my favorites.
And like you said, there's brilliant actors on the show. The set on the show is absolutely fantastic. What is the atmosphere like on that particular set? Is it ever intimidating, or is it fairly relaxed on the Walking Dead set?
I will say, my first time driving up to the Hilltop, because they take you in an ATV, which is like a four-wheeler type of thing. We go into the woods, and we're driving through all this wooded area, and then you just see the massive wall around the Hilltop. It was intimidating at first, but, you know, being there a number of times now, it actually does feel like a second home. You know, when you're inside, it's like shooting a movie in your backyard or a TV show in your backyard. You know, it's not just the set itself, which is beautiful and massive, but it's the people, you know, the cast and crew. Everybody there is just having a good time. We're eating trail mix and cracking jokes and listening to music, and it's just a good time.
And you said then you've got a good relationship with the kind of cast and crew, particularly with the cast. Of course, there's characters that can be killed off at any time. We saw in recent episode, spoilers for those of you who haven't seen it, but of course Tobin is one of those characters who, after a few scenes with you, is killed off. Is it difficult to lose actors like that, who you've spent the last couple of episodes being so close with?
Oh yeah, I think it's definitely tough. Yeah, with anybody on the show, losing anybody, because we're all going through the same type of emotions and the same thing. I know even the characters that I haven't been able to meet yet, you know, from some of these different communities, I think I met most of them at this point just because we're all together. But, you know, even when I didn't know them, you kind of had this sense of community, because we're all going through the same emotions, in terms of, you know, we get a script right before we shoot it. You only get your section of the script. If you do die, you find out pretty short notice, and it's like, it kind of brings us together, because we're all on this amazing journey with such a huge fandom, and, you know, it could be over for anybody at any second. So, you know, in terms of filming and continuing on the show, your name will live on forever, but just coming back and having that sense of camaraderie with the cast. So, yeah, you definitely feel bad for anybody going through that, but at the same time, you know that it's a character that will be in the Walking Dead universe forever, which I think is awesome, and that's a testament to the fans and how big this show is.
Yeah, definitely. Now, a few other actors we've spoken to, Peter, from the show, such as Jason Warner-Smith, Josh Michael, have said that although they really like the role that they've had, it wasn't actually the first role they auditioned for, because their characters came fairly late on in the show. Eduardo is another character that isn't introduced, of course, till we meet the Hilltop, and so fairly late on in the series. Out of interest, did you audition for any other characters earlier on in the show?
I actually did not, and that's funny that you mentioned that, because I've heard that. Especially, you know, Joshua Michael and I are represented by the same agent here in Atlanta. And, you know, that's one of the shows in Atlanta that a lot of us Atlanta actors get multiple auditions for, you know. And it was the one show that I had never auditioned for multiple times, you know. And every other show that shoots here, I've auditioned for, you know, at least in the tens of times. And this was the first one I had gotten for this show. And I didn't even know what it was for to begin with. It was a whole non-disclosure agreement type of situation. And then they sent me one set of a script, and then another script, and then another script, and I just kept sending in tapes. And it was just such a slowly revealing process of what the project was. And then even the fact that I was Eduardo wasn't revealed until I got to the set.
Was it disguised under a separate name then?
Correct. Yeah, they gave me a fake, you booked so-and-so. And I was like, cool, I'm this guy. And then I showed up to set, and I told them who I was playing. And they're like, no, you're not playing that guy. You're playing Eduardo. And I was just like, what? And then they took me to this wall with all these comic book strips of my character. And, you know, it's one thing to find out you're going to be on The Walking Dead, but to find out you're also a comic book character was just, it was a lot to process. And I was super excited.
Yeah. Now, Peter, of course, we've seen this series so far. There's been some fantastic episodes in Season 8 of The Walking Dead. We've still got a fair few to go. Are you excited for fans to see how this season is going to conclude? Are we in for a bit of a ride?
Absolutely. Yeah. I think you know, I'm definitely a fan of the show as well. And I watch these episodes with you guys every single week, and it's cool to see how it plays out. But I think that this is what everybody's been waiting for. You know, it's the epic conclusion, and I think it's going to be rewarding to many fans. So yeah, it's massive. There's a lot of moving parts, but yeah, it's definitely going to pay off.
Now, Peter, moving away from The Walking Dead, of course, as we mentioned at the start, you've just had an album out. Do you mind telling us a little bit about the album? Where can people download it, and how long that kind of project has been in the pipeline for yourself?
Yes, of course. The album is called Z, just the letter Z, and I released it yesterday. And it's a very cool project because I've been working on it for about 3 months, which is not really a long time, but they're 5, 6, 7 hours a day. For 3 months, I've been writing and recording, and I do all the engineering and mixing myself, so it's been a long process. But I'm really excited about it because it's a lot about what's happening in my life right now and a lot of my experiences growing up. So yeah, it's very raw, and it's kind of like an autobiography, if you will. And people can get it on all major platforms: Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music. And they just have to search Peter Z and the letter Z.
Brilliant. And of course, it's not the only set of tracks you've released, because you've had music on iTunes and Spotify in the past. When did you kind of start being a musician, in particular singing alongside acting? Did that come first, or was acting first?
Singing was definitely first. It actually started as poetry. You know, I grew up kind of, I didn't really have a lot of friends, and I expressed myself through poetry. I was in a poetry class as a kid in elementary school. And I just really liked that form of expression and making words rhyme and kind of putting my feelings down on paper. That slowly evolved into rap and hip-hop, and then that slowly evolved into singing on the choruses, and then that turned into me mixing my own songs so that I could actually put it together. So I've been doing it since I was about 6 years old. Acting isn't something I started until I was about 15, and I'm 26 now.
And is it something you find difficult now, balancing your acting and your singing career, or have you found the right balance?
I think I found the right balance. It's definitely something that you have to put a lot of time into, but, you know, I tend to do all of my music projects on the off-season, which works out because really my schedule in the off-season is conventions and, you know, auditions and things like that, which are pretty much from home, which is nice. So, yeah, it's in the off-season, but I manage the time pretty well, and I've been able to kind of master that skill. And yeah, it's just about making sure that you know, you put the right amount of hours into it and understand that it's going to take a lot of work. And that's why I said, you know, some of these days are 6-7 hours, you know, because if I have to be at a convention on the weekend, then I'm flying out on a Friday. And so, but yeah, I think I've kind of gotten that down to a system.
Brilliant. Well, Peter, thank you very much for speaking to us today. Peter, where can people follow you and keep up with your work on social media? What platforms are you on?
I'm on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. They can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at IamPeterZ. And then Facebook is facebook.com/PeterLuisZimmerman. And yeah, that's basically it.
Fantastic. Well, Peter Zimmerman, thank you very much for joining us on the line. Make sure you check out Peter's new album as well as the remaining episodes of this season's The Walking Dead. Peter, thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much. Hi, my name is Peter Luis Zimmerman. I play Eduardo on The Walking Dead, and you're listening to Raw.